Tonight on Tom's River Schools Today, we will take a look at how some small businesses are getting a lift in downtown Tom's River.
And as always, we have a look at some of the events from around the school district. Tom's River Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
My name is Emily, and in 7 years, I'll be an alcoholic.
Hi, Emily.
I'll start drinking in 8th grade, but my parents won't really notice because I'll do okay in school and everything will seem okay, but everything won't be okay.
Kids who drink before age 15 are 5 times more likely to have alcohol problems when they're adults. So start talking before they start drinking.
Hello and welcome to Tom's River Schools Today for Wednesday, January 25th. I'm Julia.
And I'm Sam. Later on tonight, we'll take a look at how the Hooper Huskies are making this school year the best.
But up first tonight, we take a look at our elementary school happenings in our elementary happenings segment.
Starting off our elementary happenings, please bring your food for donation to Westover for Food Drive Friday. Your help can go a long way.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day. I'm Emily Lawson, and this is your random fact of the day. Did you know 12 newborns will be given to the wrong parents daily?
It's time to take a trip around the world in our 62nd road trip. Can you guess where we are today? It's now time for us to take a look at dictionary.com's word of the day. Today's word is simpatico, meaning congenial or like-minded, likable. I found our new neighbor simpatico in every respect. And now for today's sentence. When I got around to asking why she had bothered to track me down, she said it was because we were so simpatico. Now we're going to take a short break, but coming up, we take a look at our immediate happenings.
And we also take a look at your weather, so stick around. We'll be right back.
To the country, I'm gonna eat a lot of peaches. I'm moving to the country.
Audio jungle.
Welcome back. Starting off our intermediate happenings at Intermediate South, it is Seminole Spirit Day every Friday. Don't forget to wear your Seminole colors. Spirit wear is on sale in the school store.
All students are reminded if they would like to see any sporting event Intermediate South, you must go home first and return to the game with an adult.
At Intermediate East, Interact is sponsoring a fundraiser for Leukemia and Lymphoma Society called Pasta for Pennies. The Olive Garden will donate a pasta party for the homeroom that raises the most money. Please send the counted money to A106S on January 30th. The homeroom winner will be announced January 31st. The homeroom party will be after school. If the times do not match up with their lunch, thank you for your participation.
It's now time for our environmental tip of the day. Each day we'll bring you a tip that will help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
Hi, my name is Michaela Javaris with your environmental tip of the day. Put it to sleep. If you'll be away from your computer for more than 20 minutes, change it to sleep mode.
Every day on the show, we will be bringing you a tip of the day, so stay tuned tomorrow as we give you another way to help. Oh, I wasn't supposed to read that. A woman from Washington State is calling a spoken police officer her angel after he pulled her from a fiery crash, and it was all caught on camera. Ariana Cohen has more.
Spokane police officer Tim Schwering's body cam video shows him smashing this car window open with his baton, frantically trying to save a woman trapped inside her car, engulfed in flames. Kim Novak says she had gone to the store to get ice cream when she hit a pile of slush on the road. Her car shut down and she was locked inside.
I honestly believed that I may not make it out of there, that I thought I was going to die there. And so panic was definitely setting in, and I was doing everything I had within my power. I mean, I tried all the doors and tried to open them myself, and then kicking as hard as I possibly could, and started dialing 911, and the flames were shooting up. I realized it's happening that fast that it was going to get me fast too.
Her neighbor saw the flames and immediately ran to help Officer Schwering pull Kim out of the car window.
Just give me. Hold me.
Miraculously, she made it out with no injuries. The cause of the fire is still undetermined and her car is a total loss. Today, she is thanking who she calls her two angels.
It's my angel.
Hi.
Oh, my God. Oh, I'm so glad to see you again.
Glad I was there to be able to help her.
I would hope anyone would do it for me.
Officer Schwering not only helped save Kim's life, remember that ice cream she wanted? He brought her some the next day.
I always give him a hug.
I told him he's stuck with me.
It is now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we will take a look at your high school happenings.
Times over schools today. We'll be right back. You ready for the intro?
When someone abducts a child, they're not about to advertise it. But we will. Sign up at wirelessamberalerts.org to get free Amber Alert text messages on your cell phone. Help put a child abductor out of business for good. Wireless Amber Alerts. A child is calling for help.
Starting off our high school happenings, need a little help with your college entrance essay? Having difficulty with that research paper, or would you just like another set of eyes to proofread your assignment? The Writing Center provides tutors to help with all types of writing assignments. The Writing Center is now open every Tuesday and Thursday after school in W25. Ask your English teacher for further info.
Attention students and staff, the school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is open every day after school from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-hoo, Snapple, and water for $1, as well as many delicious snacks to get you energized for after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized.
Moving on, who wants a free breakfast? The homeroom who has the best attendance for the month of January will win a free breakfast. Lakewood Glue Claws is having a job fair for summer employment on February 4th, 2017 from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. They are hiring 15-year-olds for bat boys and 16-year-olds and older for positions in the food department, video production, and the kids zone. Applications available online at www.blueclaws.com. It is highly recommended that an application is completed before speed up the process, but applications will be available on site if needed. Any questions, please see Mrs. Weinberger in guidance.
Tickets for this year's musical, Young Frankenstein, will be on sale soon. The show takes place on February 2nd, 3rd, and 4th at 7 p.m. in the High School East Student Center. Stay tuned for ticket sale times. Attention, all Option 2 Personal Finance students. All students who are enrolled in Option 2 Personal Finance must complete the course by Monday, January 23rd, in order to receive credit. The final exam will be given on Monday, January 30th, Period 2, in the lecture hall.
Raider Nation shirts are back in stock. Stop by W10 and buy yours today for $15. The History Club trip is going on its 15th annual trip to medieval times. If you are interested, see Mr. Cohen in room E5B for a permission slip. The cost of the trip is $60 and will be held on Sunday, February 19th. The trip will only be available to the first 50 students to hand in their permission slips and money.
In Iowa Elementary School, principal wanted her students to see the new movie Hidden Figures, about a team of African-American women who helped NASA with some of its first successful space missions, but the school didn't have the money in the budget. But with a bit of creativity, the power of Facebook, her fourth and fifth grade students will soon have a field trip to the movies. Amanda Gilbert has a story.
Equilateral.
Your childhood dreams.
Isosceles.
Don't forget them and don't let anyone tell you you can't.
What she becomes.
A big theme in the new movie, Hidden Figures.
They let women do some things at NASA, Mr. Johnson. And it's not because we wear skirts. It's because we wear glasses.
A movie Kingsley Elementary principal Amber Dietz wants her students to see and learn from.
You'll dream really big about what you can do.
Women and minorities aren't presented in a light that our kids get to see nearly enough, and I think that this movie will create another opportunity for our students to see the perseverance of all different kinds of people.
But her school didn't have the money.
Because it was unplanned, it was kind of a last-minute dream, not something that was planned for, budgeted for.
So Wednesday afternoon, Dietz posted on Facebook asking the community to help her raise around $1,000 so she could send all her Kingsley 4th and 5th graders to see the movie.
And by the time I went to bed last night, we had reached our goal of over $1,000.
I was really excited that that Waterloo was so generous.
Other lady engineers are in the movie, and maybe someday I want to be an engineer.
And an entire community helping kids realize their full potential.
Switching to High School North, every Wednesday is Green Day at North. Remember to wear green to help get the word out about the need to recycle and energy conservation. Also at North, the art and literature magazine of Toms River North meets every Tuesday in CO4.
Moving on with school news, college visits have been scheduled. Meetings with representatives will help you in your selection process come to hear what the colleges you're interested in have to offer you. You must see Mrs. Rose in guidance to sign up in advance to attend.
Let's now take a look at what grinds our gears.
Hi, I'm Mia Sepola, and what really grinds my gears is when I feel like I'm in a haunted house, but I'm really in school.
It is now time for us to take a short break. After the break, we take a look at your 3-day forecast.
Toms River Schools Today, we'll be right back.
My
pot of gold. Your daddy's little girl till heaven hold.
It's easy to tell if you've had way too many. But what if you've had just one too many? Buzz driving is drunk driving.
Sports, Patriots and Falcon fans are not only getting ready for the Super Bowl, they are also on the lookout for memorable souvenirs. But all of those towel stickers and pennants have to come from somewhere. Alex W. went to one factory that's already in full production.
Wincraft starts their championship season early. September is when they begin creating graphics for sports teams that are playing well. This year was a toss-up right until the very end, and because of the uncertainty, the product line changed multiple times.
Super Bowl always starts for us back in the September. What we do is we start putting our plans together, we put our graphics together, deciding which new products we'd have, which products we might want to take out, starting to put the graphics. And of course, back then, the Vikings were hot and the Cowboys were hot, so that product line looked a lot different than it was what it does today.
Dave says that Wincraft assembles a wide variety of products that create lasting memories for sports fans.
The AFC, NFC championship level, what we do is our lanyards, our stickers, our flags, and of course pennants, because what happens is everybody remembers what happened with a pennant. A pennant is a sport icon that collects history.
Wincraft also has new products for the championship games this year, including a team can cooler and also full-colored beach towels. Wanda Blattner has been with Wincraft for a year and a half. She explains her day-to-day tasks as she works with another new product, the locker room towels.
First we fold them, they come out of the transfer room, we fold them, then we put the hangers on, and then we have the cards that have to go on them. We fold them, we box them, and out the door they go.
Wanda said that today is particularly busy as they try and fulfill multiple orders that contain approximately 180 towels. She did say there is one thing that would make her busy day just a little bit brighter.
Would you be a little happier today if you were folding or working on Packers towels instead of...
Definitely, but you can't have everything, so this is okay.
Let's now take a look at our three-day forecast. Coming tomorrow, it will be rain with a high of 54 and low of 34. For Friday, the sun will be back with a high of 43 and a low of 27. And for Saturday, the start of your weekend, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 39 and a low of 27. In other weather news, severe weather killed at least 19 people across the country. The brunt of the storms targeted the southeast. Now, South Georgia is under a state of emergency after a tornado outbreak killed at least 14 people. Robert Ray is in Adele, Georgia, with more on the deadly storms.
Deadly tornadoes leveled homes.
It's like you took a bomb and put it in a mobile home and exploded it.
In Georgia, trees snapped and shattered. Homes tossed and turned upside down. Now, piles of debris.
It's like you're waking up from a dream that really came true.
The tornado is part of a deadly and rare winter cluster sweeping across several states. In Mississippi, people heard the storm before it struck.
My mom said, y'all, there he goes. She sounded like just a freight train coming down the street.
In Louisiana, a tornado was strong and sudden.
The warning happened about the same time as the tornado, so I mean, we had no time to prepare.
And in Arkansas.
You could literally watch our ceiling like it was breathing. It was going up and down.
Back in Georgia, survivors of the storms forced to pick up what the tornadoes left behind.
You literally have a trailer park that looks like it's been disintegrated. You literally have just smatterings of what used to be homes thrown into the woods. You have the smell of gas, you have destroyed homes, people crying, debris everywhere.
Wrapping up tonight's show, hiding money in a mattress sounds cliche, but not if it's $20 million. And one look at pics of a frozen lake in Michigan that have gone viral, and everything becomes clear, especially the lake. Jeremy Roth has today's take a look at this.
Crazy pictures out of Michigan show a frozen lake with ice so clear, it looks like the people on it are walking on water, which I guess technically they are. Anywho, architect Andy Poigneau's surreal Facebook images of Lake Charlevoix have been shared online more than 60,000 times. The lifetime Michigan resident says this is nothing new for the lake, which he says is just incredibly clear to begin with. Authorities in the Boston area have uncovered a stash of cash that's like something straight out of Breaking Bad. Although unlike Walter's choice of walls or crawl spaces, this hiding spot was inside a mattress. $20 million in cash was found stuffed inside a box spring in a Westboro apartment. Authorities say the literal bed of money is linked to money laundering and a pyramid scheme at a Marlboro-based company that is currently under investigation. And finally, talk about making the most of a bad situation. Two men in California whose vehicle became buried in an avalanche were able to call for help and decided to pass the time waiting for responders by, what else? Taking selfies. The pair huddled under a blanket, taking photos inside the snowbound vehicle, even sharing the moment on Facebook Live before being rescued by firefighters within the hour. For Take a Look at This, I'm Jeremy Roth.
Remember, if you have a story you would like us to share,
or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send it to Interschool Mail to the TV Studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@tierschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in to TV21 throughout the day to catch the show as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website at www.trschools.com/TV21.
Well, that wraps up tonight's show. From Toms River Schools Today, I'm Sam.
And I'm Julia. Have a great night.
Talk about, but it's filled with love that's grown in southern ground, and a little bit of chicken fried, cold beer on a Friday night, a pair of jeans that fit just right.